Welcome back to My Antique Finds. How are you out there, my esteemed guests? We're so glad to have you with us today. I've been away, but I have been busy. And, hey, I'll just enjoy showing you some of the fun stuff that I've been able to find. I've gotten some great Chinese carvings. I have been so ecstatic about what I've been learning in this field. I'll even take you down to Yoruba and show you some wonderful beadwork. We'll even look at some fabulous East Coast paintings. And who knows what other surprises I'll pull out of that magic little hat I call my finds. So, hey, what do we want to start with? Oh, let me do the little things. You guys ever dealt with one of these little guys here? Little carved Italians. They probably came out in the 70s or 80s, made in Italy. He was $36.56 at Roderick St. John's. He must be an Irish football player there. You know them good Catholics, they breed good football players. But hey, there he is. Hey, these are, this was $14 in a little shop. They're $30 on eBay. They're $40 in a shop. $40, $45. People always like them for gifts. They come as doctors. It's the first football player I've ever had, though. Lawyers. So, you know, those kind of things. Let's see. Straight off the set of The Godfather. Okay, that's enough of that. I found this. I pulled the sheets back. It showed up there. But here he is, a nice terracotta horse, just a studio piece. Thought he was kind of cool. Just a nice look. So I picked it up. Thought I'd be able to put a few bucks on it. Here's another little Chinese piece. It's kind of fun. Now, you wouldn't think this is Chinese. This is actually reverse painted on glass. And you would like to find this about another 30, 40 years older. But they did these Chinese pieces. And they always did the big, tall women. Iglamaze is the proper term for reverse painted glass. I don't know if you've seen any of those. But people always did these. And they had the nice figures. And I've always enjoyed them, been able to sell them. But this one is kind of a continental look. But it's actually Chinese, sold on that market. So, pretty neat, though. Here's a little carved ivory picture frame. In the case, I had to glue the case back together today, so I can't show you that. Comes in a nice case. I'm in the midst of putting it together. All hand carved. That was $20. This was my real big find here. Look at this. There's a nice Chinese vase. All ivory. All hand carved. Now, these can be, you know, $500 to $1,000. Sometimes they come with tops. I can't tell if this one comes with the top yet or not. I'm just not that educated. If they have rings, they're better. This is a village scene, which are common, but has some damage on the bottom. I don't think this is a real rare one. I'm going to say a couple hundred bucks, $300 to retail. A lot of times you might even be able to buy it for $100, $150. If it was better carved, if it was more ornate, easily $1,000. But this was in a shop here locally, and it was $35. So real happy about that. Hey, check this out. I couldn't leave it alone. I just am in love with the concept of work. Those are all beads. Each one of those little colors are beads. Somebody hand sewn all this together. Little Yoruba, African art kind of piece there. Isn't that beautiful? Lizards. This guy's face. A bula bula bula. So really great beadwork. I bought it, and I'm going to have to live with it, because I don't know if people really care. You know, I gave $120, $130 for it. You know, I've seen them retail for $750. I've seen some of them sell for $300 to $500 on some of the websites I've looked at, but for me, just kind of a too great of a piece. Hey, if you ever find a bucket top painted like this, buy it for me, okay? Yep, there it is, just a wooden bucket top. But with a nice Pennsylvania folk art design, all old, great piece of folk art. And when you stand around and pay $5 for it in an auction, nobody bids, you're happy. Look at this little guy. Old bronze. Look at that gazelle leaping, Art Deco period all the way. Great patina on it. See if my socket says who made it. Sometimes that'll give it away because certain companies were only around so long. But that pull chain, the gray patina on it, the cord, look at the way it's fastened in there. These are copper plates all put in there. And then the triangle base, or not triangle, diamond base. There you go. Pretty cool, pretty cool. These were neat. I bought a pair of these. Actually, there were, and I bought another pair of ones with peaches, but they're Italian marble. This one's got roosters on it. They were $3.25 a piece. So I just took all four of them, you know. And I think I put $19 a piece on them. Pretty neat. The other week, I was at an auction, and this came out on a box, on a table, with another bunch of box stuff. And all I knew is that was an old iron and forge, and I had a bunch of primitive country folk art books, and I had to spend some time looking at my books. Books, not the internet. What are you going to look up on iron on the internet? You think there's an iron book out there that tells you what primitive irons were and what you're going to look at? No, a book was a quick journey, and I was able to find it. It's an old English iron broiler. It's missing the stem or the stand off the back, but the ornate ironwork, I mean, it could be $300 to $500. I bought the whole table for $30. There were a few other things in there I will easily make my money on. And that, since it's missing the piece, I'll sell it. Probably I'll put $100.50, $175 on it, and we'll see what happens with it. I'm sure somebody traveling through will want to take it back east and can get more money than I can for it. Hey, if you're out in the yard playing with the kids, be sure you take your Persian army helmet. Persian, there you go. Just in case you want to start a war. I gave $120 for that. That's probably $300. Nice little find. Oh, two of my goodies. Here you go. I don't know which one you're going to like best, but probably my favorite is the little boy here. Look at him with his boat. Look how primitive he is. Naive. He's just not naive, but he's just so well done. I got a great old canvas and a little boy with a boat. And boy, am I excited. That is money, money, money. And I've yet to figure out what I think it's worth or what I'm going to do with it, but the subject is so far there. Saturday, I drove all the way, about an hour and a half out of town. And I like to do this. You get out, you get to an auction, you try to buy something, and you have no luck. So you stand around, talk to people for a little while, think, hey, what else is there to do around town? You got any shops? And you go downtown and you just start walking around shops. And so while I'm down there, walking around shops for a few hours, I buy Chinese bowls for $5 a piece. I bought an Arc Chrome 70s Arc lamp for $18. You know, it's kind of a knockoff one, but it's easily a quick $9,500 a quarter. I bought a picture frame. I bought some great record dividers. If you like my records, you'll have to look at those. And I bought this guy. Anybody got a light? Yep, check him out. Now, this part is actually a cutout of a magazine, but the artist went ahead and then hand-touched the eyeglasses. There are little figures up here you can't see. Little people in the saloons. Little jackrabbit. No peddlers allowed. See, and he's probably a traveling salesman. Look, he's got little hobo patches. And he's just a happy-go-lucky guy. But really, one of my two favorite finds here lately. I thought you might get a kick out of that. And last but not least, let me show you one of the big guys. A little Wiener Rückstock. Hagenauer. This is what you can find sometimes in a shop. $2.50. Don't be scared to get out there and look around. But, hey, those are a few things. I'm sure I've had lots more. I hope you're having lots of successes. I looked on YouTube today, and oh my goodness, there's a bunch of new faces. And I wish you all the best. Thanks for subscribing. Pass me on to your friends, and I'll post some more. Till we meet again. Keep a song in your hearts.